We're down at Zenity Bolton. Zenity is a little spa place. Now they call it a spa. It's more of a retreat, they do yoga. And today, with my mate Johnny from Kambo Vital, and we're going to be doing a frog experience. Kambo, yeah, frog toxin on my body. I'm going to trip out, I'm going to shit out, I'm going to puke out.
Hello?
Johnny comes every Monday to Zenity and does Kambo experiences for people. So we're about to get into it.
Are you nervous, Tim?
I'm scared. I'm not going to lie. I am scared. I'm not quite sure what's going to present itself. But I'm in good hands with Johnny. I've known him for about 7 years now. But it's Kambo that's brought us back together. It's about maybe 6 years since I've seen him. So. Yeah, I'm excited, nervous. I'm going to shit myself, maybe. I'm going to puke, probably. But, you know, what don't kill us make us stronger. I know it sounds a cliche, but I like to do things that scare me. I think as a human, you've got to do things that scare you. Or else you're not going to grow. Johnny said to me, he said, set yourself an intention. Now, the problem I had with it was that I thought for about an hour to get an intention. And because I've been thinking so much, my intention for today is not to have an intention. I don't want to desire to have peace. I don't want to have zen. I'm not here for that. I'm here to spend time with my friend, with my friends, and just appreciate this moment, this experience. And I don't want anything from it apart from just to let it be and be here and now. And that's really the reason that I'm doing it. And it's nice that my mate's doing it, and we're about to reconnect. We've not seen each other for 6 years, so that just makes it even more special for me.
Kambo is known as a little frog in the jungle, known as a phylo medusa bicolor, and it secretes like a poison off to stop other animals, as a defence mechanism to stop other animals going near it. It's used by the Indigenous tribes as a vaccine of the forest to clear any malaria diseases. It's the most potent immunity boosting thing in the world. It's the most potent anti-inflammatory in the world. It contains so many peptides, healing, with a lot of healing benefits. It's used by hunters in the jungle to help them up with more energy, focus, stamina, strength, intuition. It's also used to stop them smelling. Women use it in the jungle for beauty. It's given to children from the age of 3 or 4. As a vaccine of the forest. It's pretty much everything to them. And we've got westernised, and we use it over here to treat anxiety, depression, fatigue, chronic pain, illnesses, cancer, addictions. And what it does, it's a purgative, so it works on the lymphatic system. Medicines applied to marks, burn marks on your arm or anywhere on the body, and you go through a process of releasing toxins stored after drinking water, releasing toxins stored in the liver and the lymphatic system, and giving us an internal cleanse, detoxification. In them toxins, restore any blockages, any emotional blockages, physical, spiritual, energetic blockages, and we all have them. So it gives us the chance to leave that in the bucket today, okay? I'll talk through the process, okay? I've cleansed the space, I've cleansed myself, I've cleansed you, I've cleansed the equipment. And I'm going to offer you some rapé. So rapé is a secret tobacco in the jungle. And it's used to cleanse our energies before we go into the space. Okay, it's also used to connect us to spirit, connect us to ourselves, okay?
Just chewing tobacco.
This administered by one of the nose.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah. I've been there before.
Yeah. So we're going to have this, some of this today. Okay, so we're going to sit with rapé for about 5 minutes. Yeah. I'm just sitting on medicine and we'll let it do what it's going to do. And then we're going to go into the Kambo ceremony. I'm going to match your arm 5 times, so have you got a place on your arm, Erica? Yeah, I'll probably come down here.
Is it two?
Yeah, we'll
keep it one of these areas there for one.
Probably come down. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll probably come down here. Is that okay?
Yeah, of course it's.
Right, okay. I'm going to mark your arm 5 times with a burn stick. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take the surface layer of skin off of the tissue. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then you're going to drink 2 litres of the 3 litres of water that you've got. Okay. Once you've drank the 2 litres of water, I'm going to apply a test point of the medicine. Mm-hmm. This is Kambo, okay, so I'm going to wet this and activate it, and I'm going to apply a test point of medicine to your arm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Just relax into it, surrender to the welcome the spirit of Kambo in, focusing on the intention, okay, and then 2 or 3 minutes into that, I'll apply the rest of the medicine. Okay, then you'll go through your process. You start to feel heavier, you start to feel hotter, and you'll end up releasing toxins into this body. Okay, you end up purging. You'll be in your process for about 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. Okay, if you ask you to drink water throughout the process, drink it. No way you're not going to need to. Okay, if you get a rattle out behind your head, just go with it. Okay, if you burn sage in front of your face, just go with it. Okay, I'll take the medicine off you. If you need the toilet throughout the process, let me know. Okay, we'll take the bucket with us, we'll go to the toilet, and then we'll come back and finish your ceremony as well. Yeah? 20 minutes into your process, I'll wipe the medicine off you, I'll apply some dragon's blood, which is an antiseptic from a tree, and then I'll lie you down and you can rest and recover. I'll make you some fruit tea and biscuits so you come around.
Like it.
Okay?
Any questions? Not mental, it's like it. When you're doing something like this, then, how often can somebody do this? What would you recommend?
Some people do 3 treatments in a moon cycle. So full moon to full moon, they'll do 3 treatments in 4 weeks. Right. But you know, it's as and when really. It's all sorts of different things that what we can do in the Kambo, and how we can treat things, illnesses, and parasites and stuff like that. Some people might need 3 days.
Right.
Yeah, it's as and when. But to do a They say to do 3 in the moon cycle, but you know, you might get what you want from the treatment. Yeah. So I think you'll know yourself.
Yeah, it's just I'm not here for anything apart from just to be here and now.
Yes.
And what's it? I've not got really any trauma. I've not really got any. I just like to experience things for myself.
Absolutely.
20, when was your epiphany then?
You know, I had a bit of a loose end, and you know, I had no direction in my life, and I hit a bit of a brick wall 5 years ago.
That's kind of when I moved.
That's right, yeah. In and out of the mix, in and out of prison, and stuff like that. And I was put into recovery for a year. I got a bit of psychosis, drug induced, and became homeless.
Yeah.
And I got put into recovery for 12 months. And I seen my friend who just come off an ayahuasca ceremony. And he pointed me in the direction of somebody at a yoga studio who was a Kambo practitioner. So I was given 3 Kambo treatments in 10 days, and it just cleared me up. It gave me so much clarity, it gave me direction, focus as to where I was taking the rest of my journey, the rest of my life. It was to work with this, to stay on this path. You know, it was a rocky road at the start, forever relapsing, going back to Kambo.
Yeah.
The gaps got longer, you know.
Right.
The work got deeper, I got better, and the gaps got longer. You know, it was time to start giving something back. I want people to experience this opportunity, and it's kind of been a lifeline for me, and it can be a lifeline for others. So, you know, I took it upon myself to go and do the course. And start to give back, and start to help people, you know. And I can really relate to most of my clients you know, a lot of people come and see me because they've been in places, they're in the place where I've been, and they can really help
So what's the difference between Kambo and ayahuasca then?
So ayahuasca is
obviously the psychedelic plant.
They carry the different healing properties.
Right.
Ayahuasca is can take your journey and you know, she's the queen of the forest, she'll show you what you need to see.
Yeah,
Mother Ayahuasca, and she really did show me what I needed to see.
Yeah.
And she helped me change my life.
Yeah.
All these medicines are tools that we use for us to change our own lives.
Yeah.
Whatever the intention is, you know, these are the tools that we use. Without Kambo, I wouldn't probably even be here. I wouldn't have led me on to other medicines and stuff like that. It's definitely, it's been life changing for me and for a lot of people that I'm treating now.
So how often do you do it here then for other people wanting to do it?
I do circles here every Monday.
Yeah.
I treat people.
And what is it, a Kambo circle?
A Kambo circle is like what you're going to go through now, but just more people.
More people, right?
Yeah.
So you like sharing that experience with other people?
Yeah, and everyone's going through it together, even though they're here for themselves.
Yeah.
And on their own journeys, you know, groups, like groups of guys and girls, mixed groups that really, you know, they come and they do the work together, but the work is on themselves. It's internal work.
Yeah.
You know, it's been really good.
Good one. Yeah. Like it.
Closing down the eyes. Close down the eyes. Focus on the intention. Take a deep breath in and pull the breath. Breathe through the mouth. Through the mouth. Taking deep breath in and hold it. Breathing through the mouth.
I wasn't expecting that, but fuck me.
Woo! So same frequency now, yeah? Well done. Deep breath in. Deep breath in. Deep breath in. Deep breath in. Perfect, thank you. again. And again, there you go. And again, there you go. And again, Tim. Well done, brother. Okay, and again. Well done. Yeah? Pepper? Well done, brother.
Fucking great after that.
I'm gonna lay you down and let you have a little rest again.
Yeah. Fighting a bit at first, and then when it's all let go, like that's when it started to do its thing.
Yeah.
And that release of that, when he just started crying, and that blockage, I was just like, oh my god, that felt so good.
Yeah. Kambo can really bring things to the surface.
Yeah.
Done really well, man.
Yeah.
I think it's all about just trusting, you know, and it's hard at the start, you know, that you're like, you know, you're new to it, and it's like,
Yeah, it was mid-journey. Really, really enjoyed it.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
I didn't expect the feeling of it. It just it started to pulse in my head and my body, and like I don't know, got a bit overwhelming a little bit, and then I would just like just let go, stop trying to fight it, and then that's when it happened.
You're welcome.
Yeah, that last my body going to shock because I'm shaking. It's like proper hit me. Like it's central nervous system.
It's like your body goes to a place that it's not prepared for, doesn't it?
Yes. It's like, yes, you're not used to it, you know. It's like, what's going on here? And, you know, it's like there's a wall to be, you know. You build up a wall, subconsciously you're like, what's going on?
Yeah.
Trying to get you some tea, brother? Some fruit?
Yeah.
Would you like some tea? Some tea? Yeah. Well
done, bro. Thanks, bro.
Thank you so much, man.
Love you. You've done amazing, Tim. You sat with it really well. You surrendered with really well. Apologies.
I feel like I had, but I didn't know that it was there. I don't have a let go bit of ego or something. Just kind of that last bit was really important to me. Having Johnny there, just like really, I felt all right. I felt safe. But with him being there, I was able to push myself a bit further and to go, no, I'm not done, Johnny. I know I'm not done.
And then that
That's where the communication is between the practitioner and the client. How are you feeling? Like you've got a bit more to go.
Yeah.
Because that, you know, that it's vital.
Yeah, that last bit's really important. Yes. It was sitting heavy on my chest.
Mm.
You know, like you've got like a secret and so it sits heavy on your chest, you can't. I felt like I just got rid of that secret.
Yeah.
I think I would do it.
Kambo!
Yeah.
Kambo!
Tim?
Yeah, mate?
Yeah. But
it's not shooting.
No, it doesn't sit right with me.
Nada, nada.
It doesn't sit right with me, bro.
Then give it to somebody that needs it.
Please go and get something.
No. Pass it to somebody that needs it.
Yeah.
Give it to somebody. Pass it on to someone else that needs it. Mate, I appreciate your time. You're taking your time to come out and just do one person. So you pass it on to someone else. Love you, mate. Kambo!
Drop this like a bulldog.